First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh.
So the reason why I'm doing this video today is there was this video we posted about a certain alderman trespassing and digging through two different neighbors' trash cans that we posted. Now our channel is called Southern Truth for a reason, and it's telling the truth. And there's a lot of crookedness in this place. There's also a lot of stuff hidden. And if you're going to vote somebody into office, you need to know what they're really about, not what they try to portray and then do something different once they get in. So we have a right to know everything like that. And if you need a refresher, here's a video clip of that incident.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? When you were 8 and you had bad traits, you go to school and learn the golden rule. So why are you acting like a bloody fool? If you get hot, then you must get cool. Bad boys, what you gonna do? Or what you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? You chuck it on that one, you chuck it on this one. You chuck it on your mother and you chuck it on your father. You chuck it on your brother and you chuck it on your sister. You chuck it on that one and you chuck it on me. Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Nobody now give you no break. Police now give you no break. That old soldier man now give you no break. Not even your eyes you now give you no breaks. Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what you gonna do?
And if you missed this one, here was the response that he gave from that trash digging escapade.
Oh, didn't already film me now.
I am.
Didn't already
if,
gave me.
If you were concerned about what I was looking for in that mm-hmm. garbage can, why didn't you just come out and ask me? I've always treated you decently. You've been to my house with all of your stuff, all of your concerns.
What were you looking for in the trash can?
Cards. I hired a guy to pass my campaign cards out. He took them down the street and threw them in that garbage can. And I went and got them.
That's fine.
That's as simple
the thing
as that.
Is the rest of...
Come out and ask me. Why didn't you just come out and ask me?
Because everybody around this town is crooked as hell, and you know it.
No, just you.
I have done no crooked anything,
no,
sir.
Conspiracy.
Oh, no, I'm not. Neighbor. Not when somebody steals 4 years...
Now, we've had some community members come and tell us the last few days. There was a vote on June 2nd. This particular alderman didn't get into the next seat. He's out. But apparently, according to the community, they've come around to tell us he's awfully mad at us. He thinks it's because of our video that he didn't get in. And I really do want to address that. when something like this goes on, the person's mad at whoever exposes it, but let's be real. The problem lies with the person who commits the crime, not the person who sends the message. So if this particular alderman wants to have hatred, which seems to be what the word these community members are using that he has for us, he needs to look in the mirror at his own actions, because his own actions is what caused him to not get in, not our video. All we did was just make sure it was shown that what he's really like. And everybody deserves to know the truth. That's why we call ourselves Southern Truth. So before everybody buys into that we're the problem, stop and think, because we're all responsible for our own actions. And if he wants to portray himself as a good guy, and he's doing good for the community, well, then I guess his actions should reflect that. So he needs to look in the mirror and quit blaming us and blame him his own self, because he's the one that chose to act in such a manner, regardless of his reasons. That's still trespass. So before you buy into all this, just stop and realize, I'm just a messenger. Our channel is just a messaging service. If he wanted to get in as alderman, maybe his actions should have been more pure. And maybe he should be living in his heart rather than the way he is. Cut it if you want to. Now, I had an incident last night, the two of us, and a silver, I believe it was a Jeep Cherokee with a white male in it, drove by our home last night, shortly before 9 o'clock p.m., and yelled some things out his window, really going really slow in front of our house. And the music in his background was so loud, I was trying to hear what he was saying, and he was yelling straight at us. Basically, his message to me was that white people shouldn't be talking to black people. Now, here's a question for our community. Well, not just our community, how about everybody? But I'm paying attention to my community because it's where I live right this moment, but yes, I'm concerned for the rest of the world. Question. Could that have been a white supremacist trying to start working this community in separation? Because if it was, our community needs to not fall for it and not let the race baiting go on, because whatever's happening in the inner city could happen in the suburbs. And it's up to us as a community to stand united and show we aren't going to fall for race baiting if that's what this intentions was. And the reason why I'm asking this question is we've been observing for about a week and a half now a whole bunch of out-of-state license plates, our hotels filling up with people who don't have Southern accents. And my eyes are wide open, and I'm making sure I tell people in my community to watch out and what I saw and what I see. And now I've got this vehicle riding by telling me that I shouldn't be talking to black people. You're telling that to the wrong person, because I love everybody. I don't see color. And if you do, then you're the one with the problem. Live in your heart. That's where you need to be. So in your communities, I suggest, especially the one I live in because I'm paying attention here, start watching for out-of-state license plates. Start listening to conversations around town to see if people are trying to pit you, white against black, or other races even. It doesn't matter. Our community is more predominantly black and white, and we don't have as many Mexicans or any other races. It's pretty predominant here, so that's why I'm addressing it that way. If you hear separation going on amongst your community conversations, don't fall for it. Don't let this come to our communities. This can be a beautiful place if we stand united against this. We don't want white supremacy here. We want equal living for everybody. It's up to us to make that happen and not let this happen here. So watch your communities. Aberdeen, Mississippi, watch your community, because we notice a pickup in out-of-state license plates. Are they possibly scouts for these groups, feeling out a community to see if it can be taken over fairly easy? I don't know. Ask yourself that. Does it make sense that they could be scouting to see how much they can manipulate a community before they send big groups here? seems to me it's a possibility. I don't know what their mindset is, but I'm sure as hell not going to let it happen if I can help it. I think y'all need to join in and stand united and say no to base rape. Oh, race baiting. I'm sorry. This is all just, you know, laid back video here, because so sorry for screwing up my words, but we can't fall for it. So I'm trying to give our community and other places a heads up to watch your communities for scouts coming in with out-of-state license plates who are promoting you not talk to an opposite race. Doesn't matter what race it is. We cannot let this happen. We are all one. And we stand united, and we need to show that. I don't know for sure how to do any of this. I don't think that I can ever remember I've ever had to be involved in anything like this, but it seems to me, maybe to make a statement, we all need to talk and be seen together. I don't know if it will work, but it seems like maybe a decent approach from my mindset. And let them know we're going to talk. We don't care what you say. Now, does this alderman have anything to do with this? I don't know. That's a question you can ask yourself. But the fact that my community is coming to us and telling us that he hates our guts and that he's blaming us for his election thing, and then all of a sudden now we have white people screaming at us that we shouldn't be talking to black people, the timing seems odd. So you ask yourself that. I'm not making an accusation. I'm asking a question. Is he involved in that? I don't know. Ask yourself. Could be separate. Could be nothing. Timing just seems weird. So, Mr. Alderman, I address you. Look in the mirror. Don't blame the messenger. You got something to say? Why don't you come to my face and say it? Bring witnesses, because I'll have my camera rolling. I'm not afraid of you. And you don't intimidate me. And I'm not the cause of your problem. You caused your own problem. So face it and quit blaming the messenger. Make a change.
I want to stop.
We can't.